Good morning. Welcome to Unity of Kanawha Valley for Sunday, March the 12th. We begin our service by the ringing of the bell, which is being done by our leprechaun, Danny. And I will light the Christ candle. So we ring the bell and we light the candle. It's a reminder of the spark of the divine that dwells in each and every one of us. So if you would open your bulletin, the inside cover, you'll find our opening statement. And repeat that with me. Together, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, God the good, omnipotent. And allow the truth of that statement to settle into your heart space. And repeat it with me once more. There's only one sense and one power in the universe and in my life, God the good, omnipotent. And so it is. Our songs this morning are led by Ron, accompanied by Jeff.
Good morning. Would you please stand? We'll sing Surely the Presence right inside your front cover. Please, 251.
Sure.
Thank you. Please be seated.
I almost sat down. Oh my God, I need to be back up here. Oh my. Oh, are there any first-time visitors here today? As I look around, I think everybody's family. Well, we're so glad to join us, whether you're in person or on Zoom. The energy that you share with us invigorates us. And just enough can be said about this sharing of energy and how it makes us feel and how it fills this room with love. So I say thank you to everyone here sharing their energy today. For announcements, the study group meet at 8 o'clock on Thursdays. That's in the church Zoom room. All you have to do is go to Zoom. It'll say join a meet. Type in the church phone number, 04-435-0022. Then if it asks for a password, which it may not, if it does, type in 1111. It's that easy to join book study group. The book there is discussing lessons in truth, and that is a staple of Unity Principle. It's a great foundation for learning the truth about unity and the way it helps live our lives. So that's Thursday night at 8 o'clock. The UKVV is going to participate in the YWCA Race to End Racism. This is on Saturday, April 29th at 9 o'clock. Now, the first 10 people who sign up for this through the church is sponsoring you. So these forms are here on this table, and they're back in the foyer. All you have to fill out is this part right here with your name and address and phone number and your t-shirt size. And then down here at the bottom is a medical waiver, and you have to fill out that part. So fill that out, give it to Pam, and then show up on Saturday, April 29th, wearing a Unity t-shirt. And Unity will be represented in the community in this race and racism. So, but make sure if you sign up that you can go. And if there's more than 10 people, you'll be responsible for your own registering fee. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Oh, you can walk or you can run. They have a walking path and they have a running path. So whichever one you feel comfortable. So even though it's a run to end racism, you can walk that. Yeah, and I have seen people pushing baby carriages, so you can also be, Okay, so keep that in mind. Still collecting luggage and backpacks for the kids at the Davis shelter. Just bring the items here to the church, and Dewey Lester will get into the shelter. For Sojourner shelter, they are requesting deodorants, new towels, new washcloth, and all kinds of wipes. There's a bear down at the end of the step in the activity room. If you place those items there, Pam gets those to the shelter. We are a tithing church. 10% of everything that comes in goes out to bless others. And in the month of March, our tithe is going to West Virginia Child Advocacy Network. Now, here's the announcement that's nearest and dearest to my heart, and that is 2 weeks from today, downstairs in the activity room, we will have an affirmative prayer workshop. This is open to anyone who wants to know more about the Unity Way to Pray. And I'm going to, this is our sign-up sheet. We have several people in it already. Go ahead and pass it around if you want to join us. The church is going to provide lunch for us, so that's why we need people to sign up so we know how much food to have. But I wanted to share with you from yesterday's Daily Word. And the Daily Word was, pray for others. But it says, drawing from the source substance of all it is, I feel no need to save or fix others. My prayer emerges instead as a beautiful affirmation of love, joy, and peace overflowing in the lives of those for whom I pray. They're full and their souls at ease. And when I read that yesterday, I'm like, that is the essence of unity prayer. We don't pray to fix you. We don't pray to save you. We pray so that as a beautiful affirmation, love, joy, and peace overflowing in the lives of those for whom we pray. So if you want to know more about that, more about how there is a blessing for others, and how you can bless others, come to our work after the service 2 weeks from today. This is also a chance for anyone whose heart is calling them to be a prayer chaplain. This is your foundational workshop that you do want to end. And I have asked Beth to say a few words about her experience as a prayer chaplain.
I have to say that becoming a prayer chaplain started several years ago. I was talking with Megan Lyons, one of our beautiful members of Unity, and I wanted a deeper sense of practice of prayer. I never went to Methodist Church when I was younger, but just didn't have a connection. And so when I talked to her, we shared a lot of different ideas and meanings, and along the way, Alexa, a full friend and soul sister, said, I think you would make a great prayer chaplain. And so I gave a thought, and I started feeling that it was a calling. And being a prayer chaplain, with each call or when we talk each individual to connect with sacred space, which is calling the presence of God, and feeling it, believing it, listening to what you are sharing with us when we make the calls, and praying together is so powerful and meaningful and loving. Feel and believe everything that we pray, that we see good in everything that we feel and pray. So it's meant the world to me, and I have loved and will continue to prayer chaplain for Unity. Oh, by the way, I would like to share and thank you to Sharon and Janet. They have created this magnificent prayer chaplain group that is here for you, and we share love, but with them, it would be probably non-existent. So thank you, Sharon, and thank you, Janet.
Thank you. I have to follow that. I did want people on Zoom to know, because there have been some inquiries, would they be able to attend the workshop? Well, this is an interactive workshop, so it's going to kind of be hard to do both at one time. So what I am proposing is that we'll have, in 2 weeks, we'll have the workshop for everybody who can be here physically, and those who cannot, we will have a Zoom workshop maybe a week or two later. So I will keep you posted on that. We don't want to leave you out. It's just I'm not tech savvy enough to figure out how to do thing at once, and so I apologize. I think that's all the announcements we have for today. So I will think Ron has a song for us. Or do we have the prayer first? Okay. Mary Ann's going to lead us in meditation.
Good morning. Let's prepare for meditation. Get comfortable as possible. You wish to have your hands relaxed, resting on your lap, palms facing up. Close your eyes or soften your gaze, and be aware of your breath. Feel cool air moving in through your nostrils and the warm air moving out through your nostrils. Mindful breathing helps you to be in the present moment. It is the only moment you have any control over, right here, right now. The more you follow your breath, the more calm and serene you will feel. Let your breath come and go on its own accord. Nice and easy, so relax. You aren't so much breathing, but being breathed. All you haven't noticed, someone has been taking care of the breath for eternity. Feel divine energy flowing in through your hands, throughout your entire body. You are a radiant being of God's light, and only God's light. You radiate that light to everyone and to everything. You are as much a part of God as God is a part of you. Now I'm going to be silent as we un with the one mind, one presence that permeates all of creation. Feel yourself being part of this creation. Allow yourself to breathe into that space for a couple of moments and feel the indwelling spirit. You may wish to silently pray or simply rest in the healing flow of divine energy. Now as you return to the room, feeling centered in heart and mind, you continue to feel the oneness of God. You see everyone as spiritual beings sharing a message from hearts. The message is that we are never alone. God is always here. And we are all one with our Creator. We are so grateful for this truth. And we say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And so it is. Amen.
Daily word today is illuminate. I welcome the light. Taking a moment to appreciate the beauty of a sunset, I realize that in another part of the world, the first rays of a rising sun are bringing light to morning sky. Whether I consider or not, the sun stops shining. Somewhere a new day is dawning. Much more brilliantly than the sun, the light of God too is always shining. Sometimes my thoughts may be so focused on a challenging life situation that I do not sense the divine light. Then, in a flash of insight, I experience again the illuminating presence that even in my darkest moments is as near as my next thought. I affirm, let there be light. I breathe out frustration and worry. Breathing in, I am filled with the light of truth. Truth illuminates my mind and shine within my heart. Then God said, let there be light, and there was light. Genesis 1.
When I saw the lesson this morning, the song came to mind.
Thank you.
And if you're ever out in the Charleston area and you see somebody dancing, guess what? I bet it's Mary Lou and Jim. Mary Louise has a website, which she calls Lovely Light Living. And I think that pretty much sums up our Mary Louise. She's lovely, she's light, and boy does she enjoy living. So let's go to Mary Louise as she just says, you are not alone.
Thank you, everybody. That was a very nice introduction. Today, well, hello, I see all kinds of friends out there. Thank you. Let's just do a little meditation to start out. I would like for you to take your hand right here and go over your eye and around your eye and back up. So we're just waking up our eyes a little bit. It's excellent for your eyes. And you know, we are, DNA is a figure eight. So let's do a figure eight. Just raise up, bring your arms down. So I teach a moving meditation. Swim a little bit down here and come on back up. Good job, everybody. Good. Right. My lesson today is you are never alone. I learned this as a very small child. My grandmother shared with me a Bible verse. Every time I had these little diaries, and every time I asked my grandma to write a diary, she would always write this certain Bible verse. And the Bible verse was, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lead not into thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct path." How they talked a long time ago in that culture. But I learned later from the New Testament that Jesus said you could even call God Daddy. Abba's how they called him. Abba was the word back then. So you could call that God Daddy. You could have a personal relationship with God. And you can have friendly names for God. And so my name that I've learned to call God is Divine Love. So I would translate that verse into... Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. No, trust in divine love with all thine heart. And lean not unto your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge love, and love will direct your path. So I have a little game for you to play today that I would like for you to, I will explain the reason why we're doing this later. I made some artwork. Okay, this is a square, and it's on a grid. We've got 9 dots, and your job, you can go ahead and get a little piece of paper. Your job is to connect the dots with 4 lines. You're not allowed to lift your pen off the paper. All the lines have to be straight. So some ways we think about this is, we could do 1, 2, 3, 4, but then we have a dot in the middle that we forgot. Or we could go 1, 2, 3, 4, forgot that dot. So I'm going to give you a little moment to think about this, because as you can see with your conscious brain, you just can't figure it out. So I brought a little stool for me to sit on. Come right back down to where you all are. And you know, long time ago, you would see pictures of people praying, be like this, praying. Now we know that there is the third eye point right here. So you just touch that point. You know, like what we would do nowadays is maybe touch that point and just try to think. Let your consciousness go and try to get beyond your consciousness, get outside the box. Try to think about how could I solve this problem of 4 lines, 4 straight lines. And ask God if he has any ideas, how could we do this? Just breathe. Try to calm yourself. Don't try to perform or make it hard on yourself. You're going to try to think, could I get outside the box? So I'm going to show you the answer to the question. I drew you another picture. Here it is. Here's your box. And consciously, we think only of this box. Everybody saw a box when you saw the nine dots. We didn't think about how we really have all this outside the box. So, in order to make solve the problem, you start outside the box, go through these three, go straight through this one, but go past this one, outside the box, back up, outside the box, and back. So now, run four straight lines, and the way we solved it was going outside the box. So this is a picture of our life. Inside the box is our conscious area, the things that we're aware of. And that's what you all saw. But outside the box, we belong here too. So all of those friends that you thought, sometimes you felt like you were alone because you're only going to buy this box. You're trying too hard to make just this box be your life. When we can go outside the box, there's actually a verse about this in the Bible. It's in Hebrews 12. It says that we're all lay this here so you can do this a little bit. We are all running a life. And the idea is that we allow the person, we hand them on, so they can take our love and run with. Now that could be your children, that could be friends, people that are taking your love and running the race. And it says that we have a great crowd of witnesses watching all this. Well, where is that cloud of witnesses? It's outside the box. We're not really aware of where those witnesses are, but they are there. They're in our subconscious, our unconscious, where God dwells. So out there, if you had a friend that moved away, do you still have their love? Yes, you're not seeing them. You might have a memory of something you did before. It's their love that stays with you. It's the way they taught you how to love is how you're loving other people. Because we learn this. We even learn by bad examples. So this whole idea of getting on out of the box, what I wanted to share with you today, that there's all kinds of lines. There's people gone before I died, have come back, people who live far away. We ever have to be alone. The only time we're alone is if we only stay in our conscious box. So it's a pretty cool idea. Yeah? So some friends away, they're right here. They are just as close. We might not be able to see them, but right beyond though is where they are. So whenever I was, after I got divorced, I was never gone to clean in my life. It was considered only like for weak people. Well, I was definitely very weak. I needed a lot of help. And it's not for weak people, by the way. The best people go to counseling. It's a wonderful thing. They don't tell you what to do. They just give tools of what things you could think about outside the box. So my counselor was Will Messer, and I went to Kanawha Pastoral in Charleston. And he showed me this diagram, like that one. Okay, this is a picture of a conveyor belt going up, and then that's my brain. And he said to me that every day we have events in our life. And they have a conveyor belt, and they dump into our brain every single night. And then at night time, our subconscious and unconscious take all these little rocks or little events, and it separates it into long-term memory, short-term memory, oh, trash, get rid of it. Sort of like what our body does when we eat food. Some of you have vitamins, fiber, and all that, and some of it goes blood or makes tissue. There's a lot of it that we just excrete out the bottom because we don't need it anymore. Well, that's what our brains at nighttime while we are sleeping. And so his advice to me is get your sleep, Mary Louise. It's very important that you sleep. And so he said that my divorce was like a very big rock, and it went down in my head, and I was going to have to give it time. It's not like a little rock that they say, oh, okay, we'll take this and put it there and put that. You know, it needed time to do that. So the subconscious and the unconscious is really where we understand God. We don't really just even here in church, we know that God is here, we know he lives in us, but consciously it's difficult to really know God. Unconsciously, subconsciously there. And so when you sleep, your conscious and your subconscious marry. They become one. We don't know what's going on, but we know that what needs to go on is going on. So if you happen to be going through a difficult time, maybe it is you feel really alone because some big rock happened, somebody moved away, or you got divorced, or something happened. Let it drop into your mind, your subconscious. We don't work on this. It's not something we do. All we do is make sure we get sleep. And so nighttime, you can just say, I'm so glad I have a subconscious and unconscious, and they're going to take care of whatever happened today. I don't have to work hard on it. This is not my job. This is their job. And then the other thing is, if you ever had a big rock drop in, we're not supposed to go back and look at it again. Like, for instance, if you ate food and it nourishes your body, you wouldn't go look at what results were. You didn't need any more, right? You just wouldn't go doing that. But often on what we do is we have some bad experience that we judge as bad, but I'm sure that a lot of you noticed that all the bad stuff ended up being something very, very, very positive. Because your subconscious and unconscious, God working with those things made it happen that way. We're not supposed to see going and trying to put the rock back together again so we can feel all those bad feelings over again. We're supposed to say, it's gone, it's supposed to go, pressing forward. It's behind us now. That rock fell in. We don't have to worry about it anymore. When we're worrying about it, we're back into the conscious box, trying to fix stuff. And we need to get out of the box so you can figure out the problems in life that are beyond what the box is. So I teach yoga. That's the reason I'm up here in my bare feet. I want you to all see my scar. It's all healed up. Remember I broke foot? Well, what I did, that broken foot, that was an accident. That seemed like something bad. I started a YouTube channel, and I put all my healing, whatever I was doing to heal my foot, so that I might be able to help somebody else that might have a broke foot. So if you would break something, you go look it up. All the different things that I did. The YouTube channel was Mary Louise, one word, King, lovely, lovely, loving. There's a lot of things on there too. But the way I healed my foot in general was I just loved it. That was my job. The red body, which would be my subconscious, my unconscious, it did all the work. It healed it. I just loved it. And if I felt like it needed something, I would do that for it. But mainly I just sort of put love down into my foot. What I can, look. I can do anything with my foot. It's like it never even happened. There is a weight in there and five screws. So I teach yoga and I want to know you, a lot of people many people really out there, maybe not this group, are afraid of yoga. They think it's a religion and they won't do it because they think it might be something bad for them. But yoga is just movement. And movement and socialization are the two things that were going to keep us baby boomers out of the nursing home. So you don't like how I had you, doing with your eye and going down, back up. That is really, 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 really for you because we need to move our bodies. And that's what yoga does. Now you can put any thoughts behind the movement that you want. If you were doing a labyrinth and you know how it changes your direction of time, you could think, wow, I've had my life before. Thought I was going this way, but I ended up going in order to get there, right? That's what a labyrinth is all about. And actually right now, there's two labs that you can walk in Charleston, one outside at St. Mark's, and the Christ Church United Methodist has theirs open until Easter, which is an indoor one made out of parquet, and you can actually look that. It's very nice. So I'm going to do some yoga pose for you here, and I'm going to show you what they mean to me when I do them. And it has everything to do with not being alone. So if I was going to do warrior one, I would not this way. I bring my hands to heart center and I'd bring them up. And this is an example of kind of looking up into a place that I know nothing that's up there. I see clouds and sunshine, rain comes down there. Beyond the clouds, I have no conscious idea what's there. But I'm going to take gifts from that down into my heart. So I bring them down to my heart. That's what I think about rain and sunshine, how it makes food that I'm going to eat. It's going to nourish my body, so I become thankful for all those things. And then I turn to the front, and I open up, and I'm going to look over my left hand, and that is looking sideways. Instead of looking up at God, I'm looking sideways, and I'm looking at my fellow man. And I try to think, I've been given good food to eat, and I'm grateful for everything that came down from the heaven. How could I use this to benefit, making some kind of creating a favorable circumstance for somebody else? Now, I'm not done anything yet, just looking. Then we drop this hand, and we take this hand up, and we bring it up like this, and you connect heaven and earth. So I haven't done anything about what I've seen and what I've experienced. Sometimes they take their hand over their head like this for reverse warrior. Okay, and then from here, we come back up and we stretch heaven and earth, just a time of connecting the two. Then my left elbow comes down, it can be here, or elbow on, but I'll just do it this way and reach out. Now, this is all the possibilities that I could do with my energy that I'm grateful for, and all the different things that I thought maybe I could do a favorable thing for somebody else. But right there, that's what I decide on. That was my purpose. I find joy in life. And I stay right there and focus, this called side angle, and then we come back out of it. So after you've done all that, of course, you could go out and serve somebody else, right? Because you've taken it in yourself, you've looked out, trying to figure out, what could I do fair? I know I've been in love, how can I give to somebody else? But there's so many ways you could do that. We're only made really to do what our personality would want to do. So I was wondering if you might want to do some yoga poses with me today. You would need to spread out. Well, you would have to. You could always put your hand in front of someone's face. But anyway, I'm going to have you turn left. I'm sorry. Turn to the right. Put your hands in heart center. Take a good inhale. Exhale, turn to the right. Inhale. If you can put your hands up, do. You can take them above your head, your back. That's great. And think of all the blessings that come from heaven into your life. Take a moment. Inhale. Exhale. Bring your hands in heart center. Enter. Inhale. Exhale. Turn towards me. Good. Take a good inhale. Exhale. Reach out. We're going to look over our right hand. Inhale. Exhale, drop your left. Look at our fellow man. Turn your hand up. Inhale. Come on up. And over. Reach down. Push up. This is where you're just contemplating everything that has come in your conscious mind right now. H. Inhale. Bring your elbow down to your leg. Extend out your left hand. Inhale. Now here's all your possibilities, all the different possibilities that you do, and you focus on that one, because that's what your calling is. Inhale, exhale, reach, inhale, and drop. And then let's do it on the other side, so over towards the left. Your hands in heart center, inhale, reach. Good, inhale here. Exhale, bring it down to heart center. Nurture in your heart. Inhale. Exhale, turn to the front. Inhale. Exhale, reach. We're going to look over our left hand. Stretch both ways. This is like a infinity. My fear is stretching that way as far as I can, the other way. Inhale, exhale, drop your right, turn your left up. Inhale, exhale, one up. Oh, reach heaven and earth. You can push on the seat a little bit. Take it over. Inhale, exhale, reach. Good, and then bring your elbow down. Reach out, inhale. Oh, these different possibilities, but not all of them are you. Oh, that one right there is where you're called and your purpose. Inhale, exhale, come on back out. Well, thank you so much. I had a great time being here. Bring your hands up and down. Moving meditation, inhale up and down. One more time up and bring your hands into heart center. Now we have sternum bone right here. Where the microphone is, roll around. And we do that and go the other way. We're producing a hormone called oxytocin. It is your bonding hormone. So we're bonding to each other just by pressing right on the sternum. And stay, which means I honor the life within you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ushers, please come forward. Let's repeat the offering prayer that's on the inside of your bulletin, number two. Divine love, moving in and through me, blesses and multiplies all I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I give in love, I trust God, and I am grateful.
Times in our lives, we are pain, we all have sorrow. Oh, I've got the words, help me out. When you need a hand,
we all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not so strong. brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, sister, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody.
Thank you, Ron and Jeff. That was great. Let's bring our awareness to our heart space. That space is inside. There's divine love. And from this space of the divine, we bless these offerings as we have a portion in community to help bless others. Giving and receiving from an open heart, creating a divine flow of love and peace. We're so grateful for this wonderful church, grateful for everyone here today and everyone on Zoom, grateful for the wonderful music every single Sunday. Grateful for all those that share time, their talents, their treasures, and grateful for the message of unity. God loves everyone unconditionally all the time, with exception, and that we are all one with our beloved. And we say thank you for this truth. Amen. And now let's get together in a circle for our peace song and baby birthdays. Do we have any birthdays, or is anybody celebrating anything and celebrate with you? Well, I'm not seeing or hearing any birthdays, so let's go right into our peace song.
Scream.
light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Amen.
Child on this Sunday, if anybody wants us a short powerful prayer.
Attention! Mary asked the prayer chaplain today if you'd like a blessing. Ask her. You know you need one.
Ready?
A little too sweet this morning.